The goal of the conference is to bring together leaders from the government, industry, academics, and non-governmental organizations to talk about the major challenges that face both the U.S. and China in the areas of energy, water, and transportation sustainability. The U.S. and China need to work together because, in fact, these challenges are quite difficult. For example, in the energy arena, we really need to change our greenhouse gas emissions. It's not enough for one or the other country to do so. Likewise, then, we really need the discoveries that either country would make to be employed by both countries.
We know China, through this enormous economic expansion that they're going through, there are consequences in their water supplies, both the amount of water and the quality of that water. Very much so, similar to what happened in the United States when we were going through our enormous expansion. At the same time, in the United States, while we are not quite in that mode, we are dealing with continued pollution of our water, continued contamination of our drinking supplies in certain ways, and the emergence of new chemicals and new issues that we have to be dealing with on both sides. So we're both dealing with very important, very serious water quality issues. So I think it's really important for the U.S. and China to work together on these problems. We're confronting the same kinds of issues, different scales, different approaches, different issues, but coming together, learning from each other, sharing experiences, sharing technology, sharing approaches, these two massive economies, these two massive countries can do more together than they could separately.
U.S. and China are the world's top consumers of energy. They're the top emitters of greenhouse gases, and they're also the top importers of crude oil reserves. Both countries have known reserves of coal. For instance, in the U.S. we have 27% of the world's energy reserves. In China, they have 13% of the world's reserves. At the same time, it's not the most clean energy resource. So it makes a lot of sense for those two countries to work synergistically towards finding solutions to some of these grand challenges they're facing as we try to transition to a more sustainable future.
Global sustainability, a huge chunk of it is transportation related, and by bringing the US and Chinese experts together, both from government, industry and academia, to talk about sustainable transportation is really critical. Our two huge economies, both very dependent on transportation. It's very important that we put these issues on the table to do with clean vehicles, to do with how we deal with freight, how we deal with safety.
This is the short-term challenge, is the safety problem, because we have many novice drivers of various age, and they, many of their behaviors, attitudes, and many other things is totally different. And I believe the problems or the solutions we discuss maybe also apply to some other both developed and also developing countries.
I think one of the things that makes this conference different than most academic conferences is that we're bringing together academics from both countries, government agency officials from both countries, NGOs, and private industry to have this rich conversation about problems and approaches and solutions. And we're having a very large contingent of doctoral students from both countries at the same time. So while we're exploring opportunities and exploring challenges, we're also getting the next generation ready to deal with them as we go forward.
Some of the outcomes we aspire to derive from this conference are, first of all, develop some of the collaborative frameworks for the U.S. and the Chinese technology scientists, policymakers to work together in clean energy, clean vehicle, clean water technologies. We clearly need to understand better the political, the social, the cultural, the economic environment in the two nations and bring people together.
From the conference, we can identify the major challenges for sustainable transportation and also to discuss about the opportunities for the future and also promote the researchers or the funding agencies of US and China to work together to encourage the collaborative research that can benefit both countries.
I think it's going to be a very challenging and energetic meeting, because I think the interaction is very interesting, particularly from a research perspective. Basically, in this country, research is pretty much a bottom-up activity, that researchers, faculty and so on, scientists, are interested in particular problems, and then we aggregate up from that to get to a policy position. Whereas in China, obviously, there's a lot more top-down direction as to how research is done. So I think, particularly from the research perspective, it's very exciting, and I'm really looking forward to being able to talk to some of my counterparts from China who are heading up research institutes in transportation.
Whenever just the industry and government get together, there's a lot at stake for both groups. By coming to the university, we're hoping to provide these three different groups, the industry, the government, the non-governmental organizations, with a bit of a neutral ground to talk. But also we know that when you get a lot of diversity of opinion into a room, it's when, in fact, a lot of learning best occurs. And so we're hoping that this will really shake up some of the ideas that people have been thinking about, because, in fact, we don't have the solutions today. And we really need some out-of-the-box thinking to help us get towards solutions to sustainability and these really big problems of energy, water, and transportation.